Good morning, everyone. With this, I think while I am chairing this session, there are presenters who will come over and present on the topics assigned to them. But I thought just I'll take 5-7 minutes of yours to really throw some highlight on in terms of what the theme we have decided. So Kesar ji and us were sitting together, and Kesar ji was discussing with all OGTC members also. And when we thought of what should be the theme, we know this industry is a high job creation industry. That's why government is also focusing. The industry is trying to expand. So overall, it's a very important industry for any country, not only India. Wherever this industry exists, it holds a very important position. From this perspective, we thought let's think, because people are facing issues, the industry is facing issues in terms of how they run it today. So there is a change which is needed, and how this change has to be brought about is what we have to think through. So everywhere we are talking about what kind of job it can create. So today this industry, whole of India, has almost 10 million jobs. So today if we talk about how do you create 10 million more jobs, means you have to double this industry. And how it can be done, not with the present status, not with the way we run today. So we have to change the whole perspective of how we run this industry today. So my presentation outlined briefly on Indian apparel market size, how can India achieve target of 2025, manufacturing excellence is the way forward, and achieving manufacturing excellence through smart factories. So just a few broad numbers, so, and all of this I am giving so that I can set the tone for the conference for the whole day. Our exports is around $17 billion and domestic market is around $67 billion today. And if we assume that we will continue growing our exports by 9% CAGR, while there was a stagnancy which was there in last 2-3 years, but the kind of investments which are happening in this industry again, so I see that growth will come back again, and at CAGR of 9% at an optimistic level, we may reach $35 billion by in exports of garments by 2025. Domestic market definitely is growing fast. At 12% CAGR, it will be $165 billion. So we are talking about by 2025, this industry moving from $84 billion to $200 billion. This number seems high, but we have taken the growth rate at which this industry has been growing for so many years. So now when we talk about this, we are saying industry will grow more than $100 billion. For this growth, we need an investment of $12 to $15 billion. But when we talk about $12 to $15 billion investments, where it will come? All the promoters are sitting over here, and unless and until they don't make profits, I don't think people are going to invest. People are today talking about how to sustain the industry instead of saying that how do we expand the industry. So this is a dilemma which one has to answer, and the answer lies in what we'll be talking throughout the day in the conference. Today, when we talk about profitability, there are two things: market forces and manufacturing excellence. When we talk about market forces, there are competitors, there are demand-supply gap. I think there's not a lot which we can play there. But the issue is of manufacturing excellence. If we can work on manufacturing excellence, I think the profitability will come, and then big investments that we are talking about are going to happen. Now, when we talk about manufacturing excellence, I think let me just give you a definition of what we'll be talking about throughout the day. Manufacturing excellence refers to ability of manufacturers to provide high quality, competitively priced products and services in global marketplace which meets customer demands. All of us, we are in industry, understand this. But I think we have to strike on all the three aspects. One, we are talking about supply chain, then we are talking about manufacturing excellence, and then marketing. When we talk about supply chain, we need to have strategic tie-up with our suppliers. We need to use IT tools, both in supply chain, at the stage of when we are dealing with our vendors, also at our manufacturing operations. I think it's very important, and today there will be a lot of presentations in terms of how technology can be used to really make our manufacturing cost effective. And I think it is the time that we can't wait. We have to just jump into it and make it happen. Definitely marketing, when we talk about customer service, value-added services, all has to happen. But these three are the keys for that. I'll just give you one case study, briefly, only on one slide. Tile Group, based out of Hong Kong, they make 53 million garments. They have 12 manufacturing locations all over different countries. The company focuses on three things, majorly. Product innovation, IT initiative, process optimization. And believe me, I have met this company, their owners, so many times, and they don't go to buyers. Buyers come to them. So we always struggle in terms of in manufacturing that we are losing orders, orders are going elsewhere. But this is one company where they never go to buyers. When quota went out, they increase their prices instead of decreasing their prices, because the kind of services they give, nobody else can give. J.C. Penney worked with them in 1995, where they had repeat orders done in 1 week. From normally a month which you take, they could give J.C. Penney, they worked with them closely in their supply chain to give them repeat orders in 1 week. So I think, and he himself said that every year, it's a big company, I was sitting with the chairman, he said every year they spend $20 million on IT. So it's their yearly budget. So this is the kind of, because they know that the kind of service that buyer is expecting can't be done manually, we can't be operating only through people without using IT network to really embark on the kind of services that a buyer needs today. Vardhman, again, I'll not go in detail of that, but just on when we talk about smart factory concept, and I think this is what we want, that all of us should sit together, listen to all the speakers today, and really go in detail and understand what a smart factory means. We are talking about amalgamation of manufacturing excellence, ultimately leading to smart factory. So while if we talk about smart factory, we'll talk about Internet of Things, big data analytics. I think that is more important. Sometimes we go to like 3D printing, advanced robotics, artificial intelligence. Those will also come. But at least one can start with this, because in this industry, if you really work on data analytics, that's a key. And I was sitting, I think, with Nsinga yesterday, and they were giving me example in terms of how in a cricket match, if you know that, suppose you have you last 10 balls, 15 runs to score. So if the player who is a worker there, he knows that, you know, how many runs to score in how many balls, he can pace the innings and actually achieve the target. Or else he'll say, okay, now I'll hit two sixes and really get my runs. So might be in second six, he might get caught in the boundary and bowled out. So then you lose. So ultimately, if you can pace your things in such a way so that if whatever data you have already have, if this analytics is really available to you. So I think all these, what we are talking about, smart factories is the way to go forward. Definitely when we talk about features of smart factories, we are saying optimized material handling, connected, transparent, proactive, agile, like these are all terms, right? But all of this comes through when you start using it. Otherwise it looks like a consultant talking about big words and all, but ultimately once you start using it, makes your life so simple. So I think what we will say, scope of process optimization in a smart factory is manufacturing process, warehouse operations, inventory tracking, quality, maintenance, everything you have to go in for. And the last part of it is, you really know, all of us know, that advantages of smart factory: higher output, productivity, better quality of products, minimization of human error, less waste, significant improvement in timelines, end-to-end visibility, product accelerating of product life cycles, better vendor-buyer relationship. I think all of this, we talk in silos, all of this. And when we talk about smart factory, you actually can. So I would say that in today's conference, at the end of my this presentation, I would only say that think from a fresh perspective,
not from what small improvements you can do in your factory which you are running today. Think from a perspective that, okay, if I want to run my factory from whatever inputs given to us today and relook at how I do the business, I think that's a way forward to look at smart factories. Thank you.